understand that.
The man is so great, you know. Yes. So, and whenever Yuka performed the song, I wasn't there, but somebody taught them and they performed the song. So I was in Lagos when somebody came to call me that Professor Nketiah wants to see you. And I said, me?
Wow.
So they said, yes, Prof wants to see you. So I went to Professor. I thought maybe I had quoted some part of his composition that I wasn't supposed to do. So I was so scared. So when I got there, he asked me, are you the one who composed Mobodewo? I said, yes. What inspiration did you get? So he asked me a couple of questions. Then he told me that I was going to be a great composer. Wow. I left the place. I could not even remember which leg to take first.
I know, I know. For someone like that to say this to you.
So from then he became my father. And so I realized that I was picking up from the things they had done unconsciously. Yeah. You know. So Professor Nketiah didn't teach me in class, but he inspired me so much. But Professor William Nku did.
Okay.
He taught me in school. He inspired me so much, and I think that he's still the discipline of African music and African rhythm into me. And Professor John Collins.
Collins, the white man.
Yes. And Dr. Joshua Mwa.
Yes.
Yes, they were all my tutors. They all, in fact, have a lot of influence on me and my music. Mm.
And are you also mentoring other people?
Yes.
I'm sure a lot of people are taking inspiration from you from afar, but you know those you know.
Yes. I have mentored quite some musicians in this country, but I would like them to mention it themselves.
Yes, yes, yes.
But for sure, I know Kweku Frimpong, whom people call Black Handle.
Okay.
Is one of them. He's here taking pictures now.
Ah.
And he's going to be a great musician. But, yes.
Yeah, he's actually been already. You performed here before, haven't you? Yes, yes. Yeah. Yeah.
But you know, let's open the conversation up to music in general. Mm-hmm. When you listen to Ghanaian music, you know, in terms of composition, in terms of putting lyrics together, what comes to your mind? Is this the kind of music you expect to hear coming from Ghana?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are so blessed as a nation. I mean, look at what's going on. There are a lot of choirs, a lot of groups in the country, and people are doing so well. You know, music is a creative sort of thing, so you don't have to say this person is doing it right or that person is doing it right. You know, it depends on who is listening to it and who likes it. But I think that so far we are doing very, very well as a nation. Sometimes I think that we are so gifted that we don't even value what we have.
I was going to ask you that.
Yes, that's what we call the curse of abundance.
Mm-hmm.
I think that just before I got in here, David and the other panel on this show were talking about the National Theater and other things. And I was thinking that if we have someone to organize all of these things and put the gifts that we have into place, I think that there's a lot that we can do. Because right now, everybody is saying that the future of Christianity is in Africa.
Yeah.
It's dying in Europe and elsewhere. So we are sort of exporting even our Christianity, especially Pentecostalism.
Yeah.
So very soon our music is going to be all over the world. Mm-hmm. So how we respect it, how we package it, and how we encourage those who do it is very, very important. But to answer your question, we are doing well.
Great, great. Now, you have been in Ghana. Mm-hmm. You are also in the United States. You know, when you compare the two, what do you think we can do, you know, to better our chances? Like you rightly said, when we are bathing, we are singing. When we are pounding fufu, we are singing. So we take it as part of us, and you know, it's an everyday kind of thing. How do we, you know, turn the fortunes of music around? You know, because like we're mentioning that, talking about the National Theater, it appears when it comes to culture and tourism, we always say that it is part of us, so we are not really paying particular attention to it. What do we need to do? How can we change things?
Yes, I think we can change things by respecting that God has given us this gift. You know, sometimes when you talk about the government helping us or maybe the Ministry of Tourism or something, people say they don't have to do things for you. You have to find a way to do things yourself. But if, for instance, we have like an annual sort of festival for youth choirs in Ghana, for instance, if the government creates that kind of space or avenue, it will inspire a lot of people to want to do things like that. We don't have to wait for the individuals to be doing their own thing here and that kind of thing. So if we can create that kind of space where we let people who have talent show what they have, and we let the people see that the government respects and affirm what they are doing, I think it will go a long way to help us.
What is your current, I mean, you know, you're obviously you'll be a very busy person with demands from everywhere. Mm-hmm. But what does your normal day look like?
Mm-hmm. My normal day, these days I teach. Mm. I teach at Wisconsin International University.
Okay.
Yes, we have a music department there. I teach there. And then there are other places where I also teach on part-time basis, like the Pentecost Theological Seminary. They do have a music program there.
Okay.
Yes, so I help there too sometimes. And then I run what we call the Institute of Church Music Ghana.
Mm. Okay.
It's for people who are already in music in the church, you know, who don't have the time to go to school for 3 years to study music or something, but they want to polish up.
Mm.
So we meet them in the evenings and then we help them. That kind of. So I plan for all of these and then I organize workshops and things like that.
Mm.
Mm. There's a question that I have, it's ringing in my head. You know, among Christendom, there's this, people have divided opinions on this issue with music,
mm-hmm.
whether, you know, as somebody who is a person of faith,
mm-hmm.
should you exclusively, you know, listen to and participate in Christian music, or is it okay as a Christian to also, you know, listen to other genres of music,
mm-hmm.
you know, that are not necessarily Christian?
Mm-hmm.
What's your take on it as somebody who has come from a place of, I mean, you're born into church, mm-hmm. you've been part of church, you're a reverend minister's mm-hmm. son, and a reverend yourself,
mm-hmm.
you know, and a consummate musician at that.
Mm-hmm.
What's your take on this?
Mm-hmm. All right. David, thank you very much. I think this has been debated here and there. There are churches who say you shouldn't even play music in the church at all.
Yeah.
The churches who don't, you know, support the playing of instruments. They say you should only sing it with your voices.
Mm.
And there are others who don't mind anything. Well, I think it all depends on your faith. Now, you're talking about a Christian, mm-hmm. talking about two people here, someone who is not a Christian, mm-hmm. someone who is a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
If the person is not a Christian, they don't mind
that's
whether
true.
The music is Christian or secular, we should say. But if the person is a Christian, it's where the problem is.
Yes.
Then you ask whether the person should listen to Abin Waha or they should not listen to it.
That's I like that Lumba, by the way.
Yeah, yes, I love Lumba too. So David, I think it all depends on one's faith.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where, and
okay.
The
so what it is that you personally believe?
What? Yeah. Yes. And it was Charles Wesley, you know, I'm a Methodist. It was John Wesley, actually, who said that when your faith, you have that kind of faith that trembles before people who are worldly, then you need to, you know, go and work on your faith, you know, that kind of thing. So if you say there are witches in my house, or I'm living here, that means they have run you out.
Of course.
Okay. You know that, but so it should be the other round. It mm-hmm. should be the witches should either say because
you are
of
here,
you,
so
we
they are
running. Yes, that kind of. So it depends on the level of your faith.
Yeah.
If your faith is not that strong, because music has that power, you know.